This is the Gaumont British News, presenting the world to the world. Most people in Britain today know something about mobile guns. Those who do will feel glad that they haven't got this sort outside the front door. It's one of the Army's latest, a 12-inch. And it has its own railway to ride on. It has a crew that looks after it as a ship's crew looks after a ship. Heavy artillery has been called the queen of the battle. Certainly it is a weapon of royal splendor. It is a long-range howitzer that hurls into the enemy's defenses a load of exploding metal weighing 750 pounds.
Get off that gun, number one, and hurry about it!
Artillery blasts away for the infantry and tanks to advance. And here's a demonstration somewhere in Britain of the cooperation of artillery, infantry, and engineers. Collapsible boats take the sappers across the stream to work on the far side. Boats return to make a pontoon for marching columns of infantry. There's heavy stuff too in a modern army. Great girders fitted together like a boy's toy on a giant scale. Steel strength to bridge a stream and make a crossing for tanks and lorries and Bren carriers. Sorts of trades in the army of 1940, and bridge building is not the least important. The Royal Engineers work with speed but without haste. In a matter of minutes, their bridges are shaping into readiness. Again, the roar of the big guns split the eardrums. Advance goes on. Thousands of men and masses of war machines can go forward to win new ground. One more river is crossed towards victory.